Hello everyone, this is Millie with the Octoparse. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to extract product information from an e-commerce website like eBay using the Octoparse 8 Advanced Mode. As you scroll down the page, you'll see all the product listings separated across different pages. To obtain all the product information, we need to tell the bot to paginate when it finishes scraping the current page. I'll demonstrate how to get all the product information from all pages. Alright, let's dive right in. Step 1. Input a target URL. To begin with, build a new task by entering the website URL. Octoparse will detect the website while loading. Once the auto-detection gets completed, you'll notice that Octoparse pre-selects some of the elements automatically for your convenience. This is a time-saving feature as we don't need to select manually anymore. More importantly, it saves us the efforts from fixing the XPath. If the selected items are what you expected, you can confirm the step by clicking Save Settings. Otherwise, you can switch the detection result to find the best fit. If none of them get you the data as needed, you can also edit the task manually. Step 2. Edit the extraction settings. Once we confirm the detection, you'll see a preview of the end result. It allows us to exclude and delete certain columns by clicking the trash bin. You can even sort the data orders by simple drag and drop to edit the layout as the way you want. Right now, the data looks good to me. Let's head back to the Tips panel and refine the workflow. As the eBay listing page is quite lengthy, it's better to make sure the web page is fully loaded before the bot takes any action. To do so, we need to tell Octoparse to keep scrolling down until all the content is displayed. For a lengthy web page like this one, it may need to take roughly 10 scrolls with an interval of 1 second to reach the bottom of the page. Great! Now let's set up the pagination as I mentioned earlier. Octoparse should already have built the pagination for you during the auto-detection. However, if Octoparse fails to locate the next page button correctly, you can always modify the step by clicking the right button. Step 3. Recheck the workflow and start extraction. Okay, it looks like we have everything we need. Click Save Settings to proceed. You'll see a workflow appearing on the left-hand side. Once the workflow is created, you can easily edit the procedure by drag and drop when needed. For instance, if you decide to adjust the order of scraping activities, you can drag the box to the part of the workflow to change the order. We just finished setting up the crawler. Now let's run the crawler to see if it gets the data that we need. Click Save and Run, and you should be able to see the scraping process in the pop-up. Step 4. Manage the tasks. Once the crawler has completed, you can find it from the dashboard. The dashboard allows you to execute and cease the action whenever needed. You can also export and share the task with your colleagues. As you handle a number of tasks, assign the crawlers into different groups to manage them easier within clicks. That's everything for this video. Are you ready to make your own crawler? Be sure to check the description box. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to visit our help center or shoot us an email at support@octoparse.com. I'll see you all in our next video.